As the President's Homeland Security and Counterterrorism Advisor, every morning I meet with the President. During the past 2 years that I've held this job, though, more and more often, more and more weeks, more and more mornings, those daily briefings include discussions about cyber threats, because it's a national security and a homeland security issue, and it goes directly to the economic security of our nation. Cyber threats against American interests are increasing in their frequency, in their scale, in their sophistication, and in the severity of their impact. We're seeing threats from a wide range of actors, targeting a more diverse set of systems and using a larger variety of delivery methods to inflict damage. The number of victims is expanding at an unprecedented clip, so that today no one connected to the internet is immune, from businesses and consumers to governments and private citizens. Each hour, we know that state and non-state actors, terrorists, hackers, criminals, are probing our networks, seeking to steal, to spy, to manipulate, and to destroy. To put it bluntly, the cyber threat is becoming more diverse, it's becoming more sophisticated and more dangerous. So that's why we're here. We are at a transformational moment in the evolution of the cyber threat. Unless we take action to strengthen our partnerships, most importantly, I would argue, between the government and the private sector, and unless we develop a sustainable and resilient set of defenses, I worry that malicious attacks like the one that took place against Sony Pictures Entertainment could become the norm. If we have information in the government about a significant threat to your business, we are going to do our utmost to share it. At the same time, this will only work if the information flows two ways.